Purdue University is an international leader in technology transfer and startup creation. One of those startups is GeniPhys, which is commercializing a collagen matrix technology for tissue generation that could help scientists study how drugs affect cell behaviors in an environment that resembles and responds more like human cells than conventional methods. Sherry Harbin, a professor in the Purdue Weldon School of Biomedical Engineering and founder of GeniPhys, developed the technology.
So what we have done over the last 15 years is unlock the secrets behind the bioinstructive scaffold that cells live in, and that's known as the extracellular matrix. Bioinstructive collagen polymers are like the Lego building kit for tissues and organs. They are the fundamental building blocks, and they allow you to customize the design of a tissue, bringing the ability to entrap cells and then instruct them down specific lineages. For example, you can take naive stem cells and guide them to turn into adipose or fat tissues. You can then design the material to instruct them to turn into bone. This really brings engineering design to tissue engineering and regenerative medicine.
The American Society of Testing and Materials International, or ASTM, recognizes this technology as the first standardized tunable collagen polymer for use in research and medical applications.
I had the opportunity to work with folks at the ASTM as well as other industries, the FDA, and other academic institutions to develop the specific guidance document for these new innovative collagen polymers that we developed. In this way, we developed and defined how you would manufacture and then characterize and test the performance and safety of these materials.
Harbin's technologies can help researchers with in vitro model tissues for drug discovery, toxicity testing, and basic cell and tissue research. With design and creation of tissue and organ constructs, with controlled delivery of therapeutic cells and drugs, and with 3D bioprinting.
Now you have 3D bioprinting. That's complex and complicated because now what you want to do is print biological materials and even cells. We can use an example such as a ligament, okay? A ligament is a soft tissue and it's very fibrous on one end, and then it transitions into its connection with a bone, which is mineralized. So the ability to go layer by layer or point by point in terms of depositing materials would allow us to basically design very complex tissues which can't be fabricated to date.
The use of 3D bioprinting and next generation biomaterials will continue to grow as research and development of the technology advances.
So what we're looking for right now is to secure a strategic business partner or a significant funding investment that'll allow us to put in place our own manufacturing facility for both research and medical grade polymers, as well as our initial medical product lines.
To find more about tissue generation and GeniPhys, visit GeniPhys.com. To find more information about this and other Purdue technologies, visit otc-prf.org/otc.